All right, so today we're going to be taking a look at the Yeezy 500 slates, but before we do that, make sure to like, subscribe, and there's actually no song of the week just because I couldn't pick one song off of the new Polo G album, so just go check out the whole album. It is fucking amazing. In my opinion, his best album, and honestly, maybe it's too early to say this, but probably top five albums of the whole year, because it's that fucking good. Literally every single song on there is a banger. Like, he did not make one bad song on the album. Just go check it out. It's amazing. But yeah, anyways, let's get right into the review of the Yeezy 500 slates. All right, so this is the box that it comes in. And you can't really tell, but it's really big. Pause. Like, it's a fucking huge box. And it just says 500 on the top. It doesn't say anything on the side, on these sides at least. Normally it says boost, but there's actually no boost in this shoe. So that's why it doesn't say anything. Yeezy 500 made by Adidas. I got a 9.5 just because I always go up half a size in Yeezys. And the official colorway is slate. And yeah, there's nothing too crazy. The reason it doesn't say boost is because it's actually doesn't have boost, has ortholite in it, just so you guys know. But yeah, let me show you guys the shoes. All right, so this is how they look straight out the box. I just took them out. And in my opinion, they look really good. I know the new colorway just came out this weekend, I believe, or last weekend, something like that. And I'm not a really big fan of that colorway. Retail was $200, in case you guys didn't know. But yeah, I'm not a really big fan of that colorway just because I don't like how they like put like two browns and like a blue together. It just didn't look nice, in my opinion. But these are really dope. I got these from the Adidas app. They gave people exclusive access, and I was one of those people, so I got them. And this is how the insole looks. It's ortholite because there's no boost. And I don't know if you could tell, materials, really nice buttery suede. You can see the color just change. And they actually put like a nice like neoprene material on this. I believe usually it's mesh on the Yeezy 500 lows. But yeah, it's like a nice neoprene. They have like a nice leather on the side. And there's actually some 3M on the shoe. I'll show you guys after I like finish filming this part. But yeah, there's some 3M everywhere. I'll show you guys that in a second. Some nice soft neoprene. That's how it looks like without the insole. And I don't know if it's just me, but these remind me a lot of the Jordan 11s. Maybe it's just because of the shape. But that's what they remind me of, specifically the Jordan 11 Jeters. I don't know why. Maybe it's because it's like kind of similar colorway. And in my opinion, I do not like how this looks right here, like the tongue. It just looks like really thick. I don't know how else to explain it. Like, it looks super thick and I don't really like that. Okay, this is the outsole. Adidas. They just kept it with like the regular 500 outsole. Except their high top, that's pretty, it just looks like they extended it, honestly, from like the regular 500s. It doesn't really look too different from those. It literally just looks like they extended it. Nah, these shoes are dope though. Like, in my opinion, you guys should definitely pick these up. I'll let you guys know on the sizing. I'm assuming I got the right size. I always go half a size up in Yeezys. Yeah, this is the tags that it comes with. But yeah, let me show you guys the 3M on the shoes. Okay, so this is how it looks like with the flash on. And in my opinion, from this angle, it looks so fucking sick because they just picked the perfect spots to put 3M. Like, it looks fucking amazing. I kind of wish they added maybe like 3M like right here so it makes like a W or something. But honestly, no complaints. They look really good. Spin them around one more time. This angle, like just from the side angle, it looks amazing. But yeah, let's show you guys how they look on feet. All right, so this is how they look on feet. And now that I look at them while sitting down, at least the tongue doesn't bother me too much. But the only thing that's bothering me is this part right here. I really don't like that. I don't know, maybe you guys like that part, but yeah, the tongue doesn't bother me too much. And they look really dope. Like, I would not wear these like during the summer, maybe, because they'll probably get hot. But yeah, let's take a look at them. Yeah, they look good. I like them. And yeah, they do feel like a Jordan 11.
like just how they are. But they're really fucking good. They look good. Like, I don't like the new colorway. I don't know how you would like wear the new colorway, but just this pair looks fucking amazing. Let's take a look at them. Okay, let me show you guys a different angle. Yeah, they look really good. All right, but let me show you guys with the 3M. Okay, so this is how they look like with the flash on. And in my opinion, this brings the shoe to like a whole new level. Like, look at them. They look fucking amazing with the flash on. They really pick like the best parts to have 3M. Here, let me show you guys standing up. Yeah, the shoe looks really fucking good. I'll show you guys a different angle. In case you guys were wondering, it's just regular Champion sweatpants, nothing too crazy. But yeah, they look really good. I like how they put the 3M everywhere. I still don't like this part, but nothing you can do about that. Yeah, it just looks so good with the 3M. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to like, subscribe, and let me know what you guys think about the shoes in the comments. Thanks for watching.